All right. Gentlemen, Big Basket presents Decoding Nutrition with me and Sid, and joining us today is Dr. Ruchir Lavate. Subscribe to this channel. There's going to be lots more about health, nutrition on this channel. Today we are discussing, gentlemen, my BMR, which is basal metabolic rate.
Yes. Yeah.
Is whatever, 2000 calories a day.
Hmm.
Yeah. Is that a good? Is 2000 calories good?
That's in the range where usually men have a higher calorie, higher basal metabolic rate.
Hmm.
So yes, 1800 to 2200.
Oh, so 2000 is good.
Yeah.
It's good.
So men have between 1800 to 2200. Okay, I began at whatever, 45% body fat.
Hmm.
That's now come down to, I'm at about 27% roughly.
Yeah.
According to my body comp test, it said I have about between 68 to 70 kg of muscle.
Hmm.
Different machines give you a different result. So is there like a muscle to fat ratio that's ideal?
There's a range that is ideal.
Okay.
And it's different for men as well as women.
Okay.
For men, it is between 8 to 20% of body fat.
8% body fat?
Not a lot of people have that.
Yeah, that's like, because you're basically Hrithik Roshan.
Yeah. But that's the range for men.
For 8 to 20%, okay.
Yeah. And for women, it is 15 to 25%.
Why is it higher for women?
Women naturally have more fat reserves, given the physical characteristics of...
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Okay, got it. So
And there are some differences in geography as well.
Hmm.
So a lot of these standards are made according to Western studies.
Hmm.
But now most studies are coming out that the Indian physiology may not exactly replicate what Western physiology is.
Hmm.
So Indian men and women seem to have a little higher on average fat percentage.
Hmm.
So you should not really compare it 1:1. So an Indian man with the same level of effort, same level of exercise, same amount of calorie intake might have 3-4 percentage points higher fat reserve as compared to a Western man.
Is that a good thing, like Indians having a higher fat percentage?
So we don't really know why there is this difference. We know that genetically that has been the case.
It actually has a name as well, right? The Indian phenotype.
Yeah, the skinny
fat. The South Asian phenotype is what it's called. If you see Indians, by and large, most of them have skinny arms and legs and a lot of weight around the midsection.
Yeah, it's called the skinny fat.
Skinny
type,
fat,
right?
Yeah. So it's been observed that people from the South Asian and especially Indian subcontinent have consistently shown this body configuration for millennia. It's been attributed to drought and erratic rainfall, harsh weather conditions.
Mm.
That caused us to have some fat reserves, you know, as a survival tactic.
Mm.
Oh.
So earlier it was helpful, not anymore.
You've seen that disappointed Pakistani man meme where he's just standing like this? I think we just evolved to have more fat reserves because we're just always like this only. Okay, got it. Yeah, I've heard the term skinny fat being thrown around. Especially all these like, you know, fitness YouTubers, they always say how to not be skinny fat. Especially me, when I've been losing all this weight, people have been warning me saying, Tanmay, don't lose this weight and end up being skinny fat. Like put on muscle while you're doing it like that. So putting on muscle is like a counter to being skinny fat.
Yes.
So you have bigger arms and you're more proportionate. And if you have more muscle, you're burning more calories at a rested state, which means your BMR is high. And if you're burning more calories at rested state, then you can afford to have more calories. And or if you're in a calorific deficit, you'll be burning fat.
Absolutely.
Yes.
That is why you should put on muscles, so then you can lose fat.
Also, because the more muscles you have, your body's metabolic pathways switch from converting glucose more into fat versus converting them into proteins.
Okay.
So that also matters because the food that you eat, where it ends up, depends on the body's metabolic state. So the more muscle you have, the more workout you're doing, the more muscle you're burning, sorry, the more muscle fibers you're tearing up so that they have to come back together, which is what hypertrophy is. All the food that you eat, more of it is diverted
used to
there.
Used to fix the
that's
wear,
another
fix
advantage.
The wear and tear.
Yeah.
I actually want to just double click on this BMR, okay? Because this, I recently read something and I don't know if it's accurate or no, which is, okay, suppose my BMR is 2000 calories, X percent of it is, X percent of the calories are used in just breathing.
Yeah.
X percent is used in while you're sleeping, X percent is used in doing something else for your body, which is processing your food or for your organs to function.
Yeah.
And apparently only a very small percentage of calories are actually burnt when you're exercising.
Correct. You can never exercise so much that you match or outburn what your basal metabolic rate is. There is so much going on in your body already. So the majority of your burning would still be because of BMR.
Ah, this is counterintuitive because people always think that if I work out more, I'll be burning more. Whereas actually, if you have more muscle on your body, you'll be burning more generally.
Generally, yes.
So you want to spend effort in actually putting on muscle. Yeah. So you're always burning more as opposed to just burning it in the gym by doing just cardio. That's good advice, gentlemen. This was a lot to process. Hopefully there's a lot for people to take away. DYOR, do your own research. Make sure you look up what you're eating and what you should be doing. And for everything else, we have Dr. Ruchir and Sid. Please follow them on Instagram. Details are in description. Subscribe to this channel for more such stuff. Gentlemen, thanks for joining me.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
See you guys next time.
Cheers.